Hello students, in yesterday class we started to discuss about third chapter, organization of data. So organization of data, it's very important to understand the socio-economic problems or issues. Without arranging or without organizing, we cannot understand the problems. So to understand easily, what we collected statistical tools or what we collected statistics, so that is we have to arrange in our way, we have to classify properly. After collection of data, the next step is we have to organize. So with the help of organization of data only, we can get clear information or clear topic about any problem, about any concept. So here we can see there are two tables. So this is marks in mathematics obtained by 100 students in an examination. Just imagine their already examination has completed about ritual, the subject of mathematics. How many students has written? That is 100 students attend the examination. Okay, and also 100 students got marks. So in this, if you see this, we cannot clarify, we cannot check clearly. So how many are got 100, how many are got below 50, how many are got above 50, how many are passed, how many are failed, how many are absent. So it is not possible to identify in this table, because each and every student marks are available here only. We can observe here, but it is not in proper way. So this is called as raw data, this is called as unclassified data, okay, this is called as unorganized data. As here also, monthly household expenditure on food, that is we have to mention in rupees, okay, in rupees you have to imagine monthly household expenditure on food, monthly expenditure by household on food, especially 50 households, there are number of how many numbers, 50, 3, 4, 5, okay. 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, 40, 45, 50. Here, 100 students. 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, 100. Okay, there are 100 students. Here, we have to identify. How we can identify? So, this is raw data, unorganized data, or unclassified data. Okay, without organized data, without classified data, we cannot say here how many are passed, how many are failed, how many are got 100, how many are got less marks, less means how many are just passed, how many are below 50, how many are above 50, how many are first class, how many are second class, how many are just passed. We have to understand here. And also how many are got the same marks. For example, this is a 47. Is there any another student got same number, same mark? We have to observe here. 47, is there? Check it once clearly. 47, is there? Yes, 47, we have to search clearly. Okay, you have to write how many have got 47 marks, 2. Then if you write ascending or descending, any. But you have to arrange properly. For example, first you have to write how many are got 100. Okay. We have to check how many. I hope only one. Yes. Next, how many are got 99? Like this, we have to calculate. If you go to the below 35, how many are got 1? Two, three, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, okay, like this. How many are 18 got below 35? How many are got 100? 1. Like this.
we can calculate average marks. How many are passed, how many are failed, how many are got out of four, how many are got first class, how many are second class. So that is we can understand with the help of organization of data. But this is unclassified data. This is unorganized data. This is called as raw data. Using this, we have to organize properly. We have to divide the properly. We have to divide. How we can divide? That the base of like alphabetic order in the name of student. Otherwise, we can classify the data. We can organize data in the name of first class. How many are in first class? Second class, right? How many are out of order? How many are failed? Like this, we have to calculate. So here, so many numbers are there. Nearby 100 students marks here available. Here, even teacher also get confusion. How many are passed? How many are failed? How many are attended? How many are outside? How many are first class? How many are second class? And what is the average marks? It's highly impossible to calculate or how to select or check. So with the help of organization of data, we can easily understand. First, we have to make it arrangement properly, like either ascending or descending. Even this is also another important table, that is monthly expenditure by households. Monthly expenditure by households, that is we have to calculate in rupees. That is 1904 rupees, 2041 rupees, 1085 rupees, 1360 rupees, 1137 rupees, 2177 rupees, 2048 rupees. What are these? It's highly impossible to say or tell. It's highly impossible to explain. So actually this is the monthly expenditure by 50 households on food. Monthly expenditure by 50 household. Okay. So then how we can write this one? First we have to write this. Like below 500 is there availability. Above 500. For example, so like we can calculate like 1180, 1137. First we have to calculate complete 1000. Okay. After that we have to calculate 2000, then the 3000, 5000, 4000, everything. So when we are make this like a perfect way, when we are make this arrangement, so that time only we can get clear picture, and that time only we can calculate the average expenditure. Average expenditure. Here highly impossible to explain how much they are expensing by like 50 households, how much they are expensing on food. It's highly impossible to explain. That's why organization of data or organized data, it's very important. Very important to understand which one, that is how much they are expensing, how much they are expensing with the help of organized data. Organized data means we have to write ascending or descending, and we have to identify like how many are got less, how many are got more, how many are that middle level, how many are get above 50, how many are get below 50. Okay, so who are poor, like who are dull, who are average. Okay, so like this also we have to calculate on the basis of their marks, and that time only we can understand easily. If you do this, we cannot understand. Even here also you can observe here. So we are, from this table, it's highly impossible to explain. So to understand this, we have to make frequency distribution. We have to arrange in the proper way. That is frequency distribution. We will discuss in next class. Even this is also we can identify average expenditure of the people or household. This is number of marks. It's a marks of 100 students. Marks of 100 students. In this, we have to divide like ascending. Like 100, 99 how many, 98 how many, 97 how many, 96 how many, 95 how many, right? And also if you go to the one like 0 how many, 0 also there. So 0 also there, see. Okay, 0 how many, then 1 how many, 2 how many, then 3 how many, 4, 5, like this we have to calculate. And that time only we can identify on the base of grade, on the base of marks, on the base of number, either ascending order or descending order. That time only we can check the problems. We can understand the problems with the help of organization of data. This is called as raw data. This is called as raw data or unclassified data or unorganized data. Okay. So with the help of organization of data only we can understand. Actually even census, what we discussed in the previous chapter, that is also. So according to 2011 census, nearby 121 crore, right?
So how they ever calculated this one? Even if they calculated like this, definitely that was the biggest problem. If they are divided in the way of gender, like male, female, literates, illiterates, employed, unemployed, adults, children, okay, occupation, if they are divided like this, definitely they will get clear picture about the population in the method of census. Okay, so even all the surveys also doing the same thing, which one? That is with the help of classification, with the help of classification only they can understand the problems or issues, whatever. So this is called as class, like unclassified data, otherwise unorganized data. So when we are dividing like this, how many have got 100, how many have got 50, how many have got below 35, how many have got first class, how many have got distinction, if you calculate like this, if you divide like this, if we make classification, that time only considered as a organized data or classification of data. So what we are collecting information through the primary and secondary sources, it is not only helpful to the calculate or understand the problem, because it's highly impossible to understand. So with the help of organization of data, that time only we can understand the problems. So that is, we can identify the average marks, we can identify the average expenditure on food by 50 households per month. We have to calculate in the list in rupees. So this is marks. Here you can observe 100 students marks, so many have got 47, 45, okay, like different marks they got. Okay, so a few are getting same marks, few are getting less marks, few are getting more, few are getting like out of four, okay, few are getting zero. First we have to classify this one. So this is raw data. When we are divide like this, how many have got 50, 20, like 100, that time that is called as classified data, organized data. Before that, unorganized. Here even in this is also, we have to write the ascending value. Ascending value 10, 20, either is 10, like 100, 500, 1000, like that also. Otherwise, highest is 5000, just imagination. That time we have to write like descending 5000, 4000, 3000, like this. So this way, we can understand the problems and we can get the solution for problems. So this is when we are divide the data in proper way to give the conclusion, the perfect conclusion, that time only it is considered as a classified data. But up to that, this is unclassified data, otherwise raw data, otherwise unorganized data. Okay, so even census, even NSS, all other types also using this type of method only. Which method? That is using the raw data. After that only they are dividing the sectors like male, female, education, educated, uneducated, occupation like employed, unemployed, poor, rich, like this also. So up to this explanation about raw data. In next class we will discuss about the classification of data. That is depends upon year, like depends upon the numbers, depends upon the time, depends upon the time, depends upon the place, depends upon the quantity, depends upon the quality. So that is we will discuss in next class. That is qualitative data, quantitative data, chronological data, spatial data, right? Okay, we will discuss that one only. Classification, chronological classification, spatial classification, qualitative classification, quantitative classification. We will discuss in next class. Thank you.